Hi friends, I am Khadir from Khadir Vlogs. I am going to share you the experience of Udaygiri trip. We are reaching Udaygiri in 1 hour. One can see a beautiful mountain of Udaygiri, which is covered with white clouds. I have to reach there. Before reaching Udaygiri, let me tell you about Udaygiri. Udaygiri is a town in Udaygiri Mandal in the Nellore district of state of Andhra Pradesh, India. You can see a beautiful mountain there which is covered with white clouds like an ice cream in a cone. I am very near to the mountain now. Let me share you some facts and information about Udaygiri Hill and Udaygiri town. One can see the beautiful mountain which is looking like a ship. The shape of a mountain is looking like a big cruise which is in a dock. This place making me curious to go and explore and to reach there and want to know about this mountain. I have started to reach this mountain on a bike. You can see in between the houses and the lanes in the street a beautiful view of mountain. You can see old structures of temples here. It may be related to 14th or 15th centuries. And this is a dargah, Mehboob Subhani Dargah, where different faiths of people come and visit here. The hill of Udaygiri is also popularly known as Sanjeevi Hills, as there are so many medicinal plants on the hill. Let's jump to the history of this Udaygiri Hills. First known history of the city was from 14th century. It was a capital of local kingdom of Langula Gajapati, chieftained to Gajapatis of Odisha. It came under rule of Krishna Devaraya of Vijayanagara around 1512. The Udaygiri fort constructed by Langula Gajapati was inaccessible on most sides. It could be only penetrated only by a jungle track in the east side and a pathway on the west side. The siege by Krishna Devaraya lasted for 18 months and resulted in defeat for Pratapa Rudra Deva of Gajapatis. After fall of Vijayanagara Empire, it was ruled by Sultan Ahmad, proxy of Abdullah Arafat. The mosque on the top of the hill has two Persian inscriptions that credits the construction of the mosque and the planting a nearby garden. To then it came under the rule of Abdullah Arafat in 1682. During the rule of Gajapatis and Vijayanagara rulers, this town grew to great splendor, and the ruins of 365 temples reflect the sculpture and architecture of various periods. One more interesting fact about this Udaygiri Hills is the crystal clear flowing water from hill states the importance of Udaygiri Hills. Experts are still not able to find the source of water coming from the hills. I have to take these steps, which are around 100 to 150 steps, from where I can check out the source of water. Let me show you, a fresh stream of water is flowing. Local people are using this water for drinking purpose. Now I have reached Kona Kalua here, where you can see a pool of water, a fresh, cool water coming from directly from the hills. Here people believe that drinking this water is very good for health. Experts like scientists, researchers, and geology department people are still not able to find the source of water coming from the hills. There you can see Udayagiri Fort. Udayagiri Fort was constructed by ruler Nangula Gajapati. To reach fort, people used to go through dense jungle track from eastern side of the state. As we are on some height of the hill, we can see the town and the fields of Udayagiri. Some best spots to visit in Udayagiri are shrines of Uday Lakshmi Devi, Lakshmi Devi Narasimha Devasthanam, Tapka, Kona, Choti Masjid and Badi Masjid. Thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. I'll come up with some more new places.